flowing down. At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you. I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe. I owe all to you, Jesus. Fears ablaze through sin and shame, or powerless. Where my
bulletin this morning, and those who are watching us on the internet, we just want to say welcome. It's so good to see everybody on this beautiful sunshiny day with the weather that we've had this week. You know, we always kind of wonder what's Sunday going to be like, because we don't know how people's roads are, and of course, illness going on this time of year. But it's so wonderful to see each and every one of you here this morning. And we hope that we have a lot of friends joining us on the internet today. Looking at things going on this week, we have food pantry on Tuesday. And then Wednesday night Bible study, we're still in John chapter 15. And birthdays and anniversaries this week. Somebody is having a birthday tomorrow. Can we stand?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday.
Tomorrow, enjoy it. I'm sure Mom and Dad are going to spoil you a bunch. Looking ahead, next Sunday we are going to have a Valentine's dinner right after church, and I'm excited to say it's being catered. Yay! Since we didn't get to do Christmas. Women, you get to be the Valentine too. And not have to do anything. So
here David was the only vote no for that. No, I'm kidding.
So we're looking forward to just getting together and having a wonderful time of fellowship next Sunday. Plan to be here, and you're welcome to invite a friend or family member to join you, and we'll just have a great time together. And on the 19th is men's breakfast, and so men, be planning for that. And invite your friends and neighbors, our family member. It's such a yummy breakfast and just a great time of fellowship that the men have. And then in prayer requests, I don't have any updates this morning, so you can see on your prayer request list. I did have several people ask me how Greg's mom, Ann, is doing. And please pray that she has that infection cleared up. This will be her second week of IV antibiotic, and just pray that the antibiotic does its job and that she won't have to continue with the IV, and hopefully the wound back can go away too. A couple of things that are holding her back, and so we'll pray for that. And I know as I go through this, I'm probably going to forget somebody, My son Ronnie is, and his wife are both doing better from COVID. He just had a sore throat yesterday, but everything else, they're over all of the rest of the symptoms and getting their energy back. And so thank you for your prayers and your concerns about my son. Marie's daughter Sandy, am I right? I sent out a prayer request because she had a possible ear infection, and yesterday she was doing better, and so not completely well, but better. So thank you all so much for your prayers. Earl is doing a little better. Larry's here, Jamie's here. Julie Stotler is having something going on in her neck again that she's got to see a doctor for. So continue to remember Julie and that she can get back with us too. So thank you all for your prayers.
Amen. Let's see, I know you can hear this. We have a communion this morning. And something as we go into communion that we always need to remember is that if we confess our sins, the Bible says that He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. And we have so many examples in the Bible of men that have made mistakes, men that haven't done what is right, but when they humble themselves before God, He had forgiven them, and His grace and mercy was shed upon them. So we have those examples in the Bible, and if He's done it for others, He'll do it for us too. So praise God for that this morning. So I'm going to read out of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, starting with verse 23, and it says, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He brake it and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, this do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also He took the cup, when He had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in the remembrance of me. For as oft as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till He come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world." See, that's the difference between us and the world, is that when we judge ourselves and ask Christ to forgive us, then we won't be judged with the world. So today, David, if you'd like to go ahead and start the music today, let us judge ourselves for just a few minutes here before we take the Lord's Supper. And if there be some wicked way within us, let us ask forgiveness and the strength and the grace to conquer that evil that is within us. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to you.
This is my body given for you. This is the cup that holds the blood of the new covenant. Before
thank you, Lord, today. We give you glory and honor and praise. And Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus, who shed his blood upon the cross that we might have remission for sins. We thank you, Lord, that once we walked in darkness and you translated us into men and women of the light. And Father, we just want to give you glory and honor today. We want to thank you. We want to thank you for your mercy and your grace, Lord. We thank you for taking us from that person that was heading the wrong way and putting our feet on the path of righteousness, Lord. We thank you, Father, for that grace that you showed upon us. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, take and eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also, he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. All right, praise God. Are we thankful today for that blood that was shed on the cross for the remission of our sins? Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap this morning. Praise God, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Donna, if you and your worship team would like to come this morning, I'm going to start off with Psalm 62, verses 5 through 8 this morning. What a glorious God we serve. Let's worship and adore him. Hallelujah. Psalm 62, verses 5 through 8. And that says, my soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectation is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. And God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God. Trust in him at all times, ye people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us. Salah. So as we go to worship this morning, let's just remember that he is our refuge this morning. Amen.
He is our refuge. He is our strength. And we want to give him thanks and praise this morning. Would you stand with us as we worship the Lord this morning for all that he's done for us? We just took communion together, remembering what Jesus did for us, making sure that our hearts are right with him. And we just want to now just give him praise and glory for all that he's done for us.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say, you're my God, you're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so high.
Forgiven.
forgiveness to me, that brought acceptance into heaven to me. And I am alive and well today because of what you did for me, Jesus. If you're standing or if you're sitting and you're breathing today, God has given you another day. It's because of his great love for you. And he has so much planned for you. And those who are watching us on Facebook and YouTube, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, today is a great day for you to come to know Jesus. Or those of you who are here in the sanctuary this morning that needs another touch from Jesus, you can just call out to him this morning, because he has provided everything that we need for the, from the death of the cross to his resurrection, seated at the right hand of the throne with the Father right now. And he's watching each and every one of us. He knows us by name. He knows us by the number of hairs on our head. And Larry, sorry, I was just thinking of you. Jesus knows everything about each and every one of us. And he knows what we have need of before we even ask. And he continues that in, day in and day out. He never lets us go, and he never forgets about us. Think about that as we sing this song and ask Jesus to not let go of you and provide for you.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm gone in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near, and I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. Oh,
lets go of his children. And every high and every low. How many of you know that life brings us struggles sometimes? That's what that song talked about. But there is going to be an end. Someday, and we believe soon, there will be an end to the struggles. But until that day comes, we're going to hold on to Jesus. We're going to let the joy of the Lord be inside of us.
Hallelujah.
We're going to let the joy of the Lord lift us up and keep us and hold us until that day, until Jesus comes.
Yes.
And this last song that we are going to sing, Chainbreaker, there are things that might be holding you back from worshiping the Lord today. You may be struggling with depression, or maybe fear, or maybe you're dealing with a life-controlling substance like drugs or alcohol or sexual addiction. You know that Jesus can break those chains.
Yes.
Jesus can take away that fear that may be keeping you from loving the Lord to your fullest potential, or from keeping you from loving others. Jesus can break every chain in your life. And those of us who have been believers for a long time or a short time, Christian believers, we do sometimes have chains that bind us, and we need to ask the Lord to help us to break those chains. I think the biggest chain that most of us deal with is fear. In these current days, the enemy is really trying to bring fear like a flood into our lives. We see it bombarding us in the media and just different things. And the enemy, if we are afraid, then we can't fully give our life to the Lord. We cannot fully look to the Lord. And Jesus wants us to look to him. And he wants to be the Lord of our life. And so we don't want the enemy to be able to have this fear over our lives or anything over our lives, because we want Jesus to be first place. And so as we sing this song, if you have a need, a chain binding you, or if you have an illness that is getting you down, reach up to Jesus. He is the chain breaker today.
Amen.
And he will break the chains.
Yes.
He will raise you up, and he will keep you.
If you've been
walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's the pain. He's a waymaker. If you need freedom, a saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker.
Believe it this morning.
Hallelujah.
We've all searched for the light of day
in the
chain breaker.
Hallelujah. You know, this week, and even in the last week, I just feel like over and over again, I just kept hearing the word of the Lord come to me, or in my Bible reading, that Jesus has all power.
Yes.
That we have given Satan way too much positive thinking, or too much credit. Satan is not equal to God.
Amen.
He does not have the same power as God. He is not omniscient. He does not know everything. He cannot read your mind. He does not have all power over you. He is not omnipresent. He can't be everywhere. And so we give the enemy a lot of credit sometimes, whenever he is nothing compared to the power of God that is in each and every one of us. And he is able to do in your life exceedingly and abundantly above anything that you can ask or think, if you just reach out to him, if you put your whole life in his hands and just trust in him. He has all the power. And I know that that's our message this morning. We're going to go on and hear the word of the Lord. Without Jesus, we can do nothing. Believe it this morning.
Amen.
To you now.
Praise God. Jesus, the chain breaker this morning.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Glory. Larry, has he broken chains in your life this morning?
Oh, yeah.
Praise God. Praise God. Ted, has he broken chains in your life this morning?
Yeah.
Amen.
Good.
As that song says, stand and testify. I just want to testify this morning about the greatness of my God. I want to stand and testify that he broke the chains that was binding this man, and he brought salvation into my life. He took me from that old man that I used to be, and he made me a new creation in Christ. And that only comes through the chain breaker, Jesus.
Yeah.
So if you're out there on Facebook and YouTube today, and you have chains of alcoholism, of drug abuse, of pornography, of lying, of cheating, whatever it may be, I want you to know that Jesus today is the chain breaker. And if you turn to him, he will make you that new creation in Christ. Because as Donna was saying this morning, he has all power. He is the creator of this whole universe and everything that is within it. And today, if we turn to Jesus and ask him to set us free, then he has that power that can set us free.
Amen.
There is nothing that binds us that cannot be broken. There is no sin that besets us that God cannot overcome. And I say today that he is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, and he is our strong tower. And today I'm running to him that my chains can be broken. Praise God. Praise God. The chain breaker. Stand up and testify. Amen. Praise God. Today I'm going to go back to the sermon that we started last week that is called, You Can Do Nothing. And I'm going to turn to John chapter 15 this morning. And I'm going to read verses 1 through 9. And I want us to understand, as we read this, that without that chain breaker, we can do nothing. But with that chain breaker, the Bible tells us that we can do all things through Christ Jesus our Lord. So let's start off with verse 1 this morning that says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing. And I want us to hear that one more time. He says, "He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing." Without Jesus, we can do nothing. "If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit. So shall ye be my disciples. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love." If you ever wondered why the world is so messed up, or so lost, maybe I should say, it's because they do not abide in the vine. They don't acknowledge God, therefore do not heed his counsel. Paul states in Galatians 5, "This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh.